So we all are very familiar with the fact that many of us have, I think, recognized it and noticed it, that Ayushman Khurrana is in a way the updated version of the idea of a common man that was represented some decades ago by Amol Palekar. So I feel that is very much true, that he is the updated common man. But I would also like to put two other common men, or another idea of a common man, which is a little different in terms of how it was used in Bollywood, in terms of what kind of films were made using that, putting that kind of common man in the center. It was different, but I still think that it was still representation of a common man, and a very similar common man as well. Similar in a sense of the circumstances that he was put into. The way he reacted to it was different, and it kept on evolving. So that is my angry young man, or that Amitabh Bachchan represented in the 70s. It originated in the 70s, and then it went on, and different other kinds of versions happened of it. And by the time in the 90s, I feel that someone like Sunny Deol represented a very, like a much more extreme version of that angry young man. The first primary difference I feel that between Amitabh Bachchan's common angry young man and Sunny Deol's angry young man is the inhumanness at which Sunny Deol was capable of doing action, and the way he wasn't, when he starts hitting people, it's not something that people can imagine I could do. And that is the difference between Amitabh Bachchan hitting people. Amitabh Bachchan didn't hit people like a superhero. Like, Amitabh Bachchan was still a common person who is just very courageous and brave, and is capable of doing tit for tat and getting back his what he deserves, and all that stuff, and his self-respect and all that stuff. Whereas Sunny Deol, when he kills people or when he hits people, there's a sense of escapism. There's a sense of there is a dream quality to him. It's also what people dream to be like Sunny Deol. Yes, they would want to be like him, and that's why Sunny Deol is more of a superhero kind of a common man. But the similarity is that both start from the same point. The starting point is that they're both part of the system, they're both part of the society, and they're not. They have to struggle because of that, and then they find a way to. There is no other way left to them than evolve and fight it, and that's the only way of survival that they have at their disposal. And then what happens is, what Amitabh Bachchan does is believable in a way. It was believable. It was also believable for the fact that while people who always talk about the angry young man, they also talk that it was decent among the people, that was in a way not expressed. Like, it was the repressed decent among the people that was the reason behind Amitabh Bachchan's angry young man becoming a more relatable protagonist and a hero. But I feel that even though it was repressed, it still, every now and then, they had examples of that kind of rage in the society. A revolution or a fight against the system, whether you call it, I think the most important one was obviously JP, the revolution that happened by JP, Jai Prakash Narayan. That was one part of it, but I feel that those things were more common in our country's politics and our social history. Whereas by the time 90s arrived, those things started becoming more difficult. And that is why you needed something extra. You needed something extreme, and you needed Sunny Deol. Now, relevant things don't work because relevant things did no longer work in the society. Now, a protest or a small kind of a revolution even cannot really make big dents to the system. It can just like needle them a little. That's all it can do. But in previous years, things were different. Like, people could see things change drastically. And that's why a protagonist like the Angry Young Man, Amitabh Bachchan's Angry Young Man, was more relatable. At the same time, in a parallel way, a different kind of common man existed in a different kind of film industry. Though not that different, because I feel that Amitabh Bachchan was such a versatile common man. He was not just an angry young man. He was a very versatile common man. And people, I think that that's the most popular image of Amitabh Bachchan. But I think Amitabh Bachchan did so many versions of common man in the 70s and 80s. He was also working with someone like Hrishikesh Mukherjee, and that was also a very, whatever characters that he played, that was also one of the crowd, like people that we could see are a part of the crowd. And they were very close to what, say, someone like Amol Palekar was doing already. He was doing it more with Basu Chatterjee, I think also with Hrishikesh Mukherjee. So that was a little different approach to little similar problems both those common mans had. They were living in the same world. They were probably facing different problems, but they were still living in the same world. Now, the update on Ayushman Khurana, the update on Amol Palekar, as we called, is Ayushman Khurana. So the thing with Ayushman Khurana is that I think the main basic difference is that that Ayushman Khurana's protagonist, Ayushman Khurana's common man, is so small in comparison to the system, is that he can never even imagine to change things. So changing things, or like Amol Palekar was, Amol Palekar's common man was, he could enjoy that luxury of not facing conflicts that someone like Amitabh Bachchan's common man was facing. Because there was a sect of a society or people, there were people for a common man, it was easy to exist in your own little world. And you could be that Amol Palekar's common man. And it was easy for you to not be bothered about everything happening around you. Whereas Ayushman Khurana, for Ayushman Khurana's protagonist, it's not possible. He is bothered by everything happening around him. But he has given up to fight against it. Like someone like Amitabh Bachchan tried fighting against him. Sunny Deol tried fighting against him on a very extreme level. But someone like Ayushman Khurana's protagonist, common man, has totally given up on that. So what he has to do to find peace with himself or to resolve his conflicts is that he has to make peace with it. If he has a problem, we see that there's always a problem that happens to him, happens in his family, happens around him, and he's irritated by it, Ayushman Khurana's character. And by the end of the film, he finds peace with it. He makes peace with it. He doesn't necessarily find a solution to the problem. The solution to the problem is him being able to accept it for what it is and being okay with it. And that's the reality of today's common man. Where a common man really is very futile and is very small in terms of the system, and he cannot change system in terms of both from a political viewpoint and also from the social viewpoint. Because what you see in Ayushman's films is the system on a social viewpoint. It's not necessarily political, but it's the social system of our society that you see that gives rise to conflicts in the story. So Ayushman has to find a way to make peace with it, and that's the only way he can get out of his misery. He cannot fight it. He cannot change it. So there is no way that he can have a climactic moment where everything works out for him. Everything will never work out for that kind of a protagonist. He has to deal with imperfections. But his inner peace is what he can really achieve in. And I feel that that is where society today has led us and you, all of us. That there is so much wrong around us. There's so huge problems around us that solving them is an unimaginable thing for an individual, for someone like a common man. who has no power, who has not enough strength to initiate any big kind of change. So the only way that we can find happiness is making peace with the problems around us, the problems that society is forcing us on as well. So that is one of the primary change. I feel that there is another common man that I have to mention here, is that is Nana Patekar. I feel that Nana Patekar was also a representation of the common man in terms of the way he, the reason why he became such a huge phenomena as well in commercial cinema. I feel that his work and Sunny Deol's work, they both were parallelly working in commercial cinema in mainstream Bollywood. One reason is that Sunny Deol was a heroic kind of a person. He was a superhero. He was a good looking guy. He could have a heroine and he could romance them as well, though he could never dance. So he had all those aspects as well. But Nana Patekar was, on the other hand, he was visually one of the like people. If they could see Nana Patekar and they could see themselves, they could also see for the fact that this is the person that belongs to us. Like he's our representative. The way he looks like a common man. He also represented rage of the common man. But the difference is that he was never part of the common society. Like Nana Patekar's character, most of the times, was always aloof. He was always an eccentric person, aloof from the society. Whereas Sunny Deol or Amitabh Bachchan's common man was more a part of the society at the beginning of the film or the beginning of the story. And then they fight it out and they stand out and they take things in their hands and they resolve conflicts and all those things happen. But in the beginning, they are as much common as they are. Like the best example is Sunny Deol in Ghatak. Like he was as common as anyone could be. And by the end, he became what he became. But Nana Patekar always is aloof from the common man. He always looks at people from a distance. His characters always look at people from distance, judge people from distance, pass commentary on people at distance. The best scene I feel that it describes this phenomena is that scene from Tiranga where, the scene from Krantivir where the politicians have arranged a rally and they're about to give a speech. And somewhere on a tree, Nana Patekar is like passing on sarcastic remarks on everything, every ashwasan that they're making, every promise that they're making. He's making sarcastic remarks and making fun of them. And people are like responding to both those things. So what we see is that Nana Patekar is not part of those people. If Sunny Deol was part of that film or Amitabh Bachchan in the earlier 70s was part of it, he would be sitting in the crowd and listening. He won't be standing aloof and telling people what's what. So that's the difference between Nana Patekar's common man. So what it means is that Nana Patekar was not necessarily the representation of a common man. He was the representation of a mirror that reflected what's happening and what the common man, what his problems are and what could be the solutions for it. He was the mirror. He acted as a mirror. He was not part of the system directly. Now the reason I think that someone like some other heroes that we could now associate are totally opposite of this. And that is why I feel that these are few, that the examples that I've given now, and probably some other, like Nasiruddin Shah could also be called in his parallel cinema movement, or the films that he worked in. But mostly I think that the difference is that Nasiruddin Shah always played characters. He didn't have one character that was repeating itself in different ways. Which in a way Amol Palekar was, what was happening with Amol Palekar. I don't think it was a conscious decision. It was happening with Amol Palekar and we were witnessing it. It has been happening with Ayushman Khurrana, but that has been more conscious. I feel that Ayushman Khurrana has been very conscious of his choices and he's consciously made that career where we see different representations of the modern common man in his filmography. But the reason why I'm saying these are very few people who do this. I think you cannot associate a common man with Shahrukh Khan or a common man with Salman Khan, even not with Akshay Kumar, even though Akshay Kumar, in a period, I think, where he was doing a lot of comedy films, he was very relatable to people. Like Raju was a very relatable character in Hera Feri, Fir Hera Feri. But those were, like, all those things were so escapist in a way that they were so loosely based on our day-to-day lives that we cannot really see an actual representation. We could see them as entertainers. We could see them as like Shahrukh Khan's romantic hero was miles away from what our life was as common people. He had nothing to do with us, but that's the fun out of it. That was the fun part of it. That's why it made those characters so charming, and he made those characters very special. And even Akshay Kumar, his foolish things, they made so much. They added so much value to us as audiences. And even I think whatever Salman Khan did in some of his films, like in Dabang, it still makes sense to us. That is the reason why, because we need all these things. But along with that, we also need relevance. We also need our own representations, which someone like Ayushman Khurana is doing it in a very main, in a very like spoon feeding us in many ways. But that is necessary. That is necessary in the mainstream, which I feel, apart from Ayushman Khurana, now very few filmmakers, very few icons of Bollywood are doing that. Most of them are playing characters, which is a good thing. Most of them are still playing characters, like Rajkumar Rao is playing a lot of characters. I think there is also another reason why that now Shah Rukh Khan's magic is not that. I mean, one from the fact that he's become old, but his generation of stars, Salman Khan and Shah Rukh Khan, and they've become old and their magic is losing its luster. But I think the real reason why I feel is that now people are a little, people are trying to find more relevance. People are a little irritated from escapism now. They want to find relevance, and that's why characters are coming in. So if not a common man, at least give us characters. At least give us some kind of relatability. And that's why more character-driven films, I feel, are coming in. And the other reason is that, which I think is the most important reason why more character-driven stories started being part of mainstream Bollywood, is that our escapism now cannot last the competition against Hollywood, against Marvel, against Disney. Like if we want to really enthrall and really like blow people's mind with our escapism, we have to spend that amount of money. We have to have that kind of expertise. I would say we do have expertise. We do have creativity. We do have expertise. We have people, all the people who work for visual effects around the world. Most of the work is done in India. But I feel that we still cannot match them. And since we cannot match them, it's better that we don't go their way and we find our own, we reinvent our own mainstream, and which is what is happening in the past few years, where we are seeing more character-driven stories. That since our mainstream cannot match the escapism of the outside world, we are finding an alternative so we are dumbing things down. We are finding characters and stories, but we are dumbing things down. We are putting them, we are repeating ourselves with heartland stories, similar conflicts, similar looking films, and all that stuff is happening. But I think still, this is not a bad time for audiences to exist in. And what we are seeing happen in South Indian cinema, or what we are seeing in Malayalam cinema and the new form Tamil cinema, the new, the slightly Vidrohi, or what kind of Vidrohi kind of Tamil cinema, is that it's the next stage of evolution. I think Bollywood is yet to achieve its first stage of evolution, which is of character-driven stories. And once we are through that, I think we will have that as well. We will have that stage of evolution as well in Bollywood. So I feel this is where I was going with. I really wanted to point out what the evolution of Common Man has been and how it's been different. So now I would see, apart from Ayushman Khurana, the in general the common man is more of like every person is different from each other. So that kind of philosophy is what people are trying to do when character driven stories are existing. But Ayushman Khurana on his own has and all his films, his filmography has tried to keep it tried to repeat himself in a way and centering towards one kind of a common man rather than multiple characters. So I think that both these things can exist together, that we can have that kind of a version of a common man and we can have characters as well in the mainstream. Yeah, but less escapism is what's gonna happen, I feel. And that is why I feel I think one actor I have to mention who has tried his his best over the years to bring that huge escapism in a very interesting way. It is Ranbir Kapoor. I feel that Ranbir Kapoor's films, or at least his future films now that are coming up, there are a lot of fantasy-oriented films. The Ayan Mukherjee film, then there is Brahmastra. Then there is a film called Shamshera, I think. I don't know how many years they're going to take to come out, really. But he has made a conscious attempt to reinvent escapism. But I think that him alone cannot do anything, or it's a collective thing. Like if the industry has to really match the escapism of the outside world, it's a collective thing that has to happen and big scale thing that has to happen. I feel that Rohit Shetty's films are not really helping us. I feel that his escapism is very mainstream. Is a very mainstream version of things that are happening around us now. A film like Suryavanshi, for example, I think is a very exciting film. Suryavanshi is, I'm a film. It's a film that I'm really excited for. But apart from that, what he made in recent times, those are very outdated stories, and the way he tells them, they're not really relevant to anyway. And the treatment given to them is also not very relevant. So it's better that Rohit Shetty makes mindless comedies. That is better, I would say, rather than making a film like Simba. Suryavanshi, I don't know what's going to happen. I mean, if it's really, really, really well done in terms of the action and all that, it might work. Like, it is binging. It is depending on the nationalist wave that has been happening in mainstream. So that could be the answer. Our new escapist, our new huge mainstream could be only based on nationalism. But I feel that we cannot only thrive on nationalism. That's one part of it. If we really need escapism, we really have to create worlds that are very different from our worlds and in the world that we live in, and which is where fantasy is the most important element. Our fantasy need not be like Marvel or Disney. It can be our own version of fantasy, whatever that is. And historical is not a fantasy. A film like Tanaji is not a fantasy, though people look at it that way, I feel, sometimes. So I feel that the only way we could match is if people respond to such experiments that happen. So a film like Shamshera, or a film like whatever, that is Brahmastra, or some other people that are also doing some fantasy films, if these films really become huge hits, that is when I feel that our producers and our distributors and our studios and all that, they will start taking bigger risks with homegrown escapist huge content. Apart from that, I think the mainstream, the more of the day-to-day basis thing will always be, in today's time, would most likely be surrounding again Heartland and dumbing down relatable characters and stories and all that stuff. That's the real staple that's going to be for the next few years, at least. Thrillers, I feel, is going to be restricted more towards the web content department, the long format, especially thrillers and all that kind of content. That would be more restricted. I think cinema people are not going to be fascinated by thrillers alone. They could be a part in the mix. They could be one aspect in the mix, but on their own, I don't see that becoming the biggest thing. It can be the biggest thing on the longer format. So yeah, that's all I wanted to speak about in this podcast.